Chris Hall, that grounder to second base, it seemed like that kind of sort of changed everything.
Yeah, it did. It did change the game a lot. It gave us a great 90, mm-hmm. like we expect our players to do, and Chris Hall does it better than him, and it did change the whole complexion of the game. I'm proud of our guys. Mm. This was a challenging game for them. They're out of school. It's sandwiched between two weekend series that were big for us. Last weekend it slipped away from us. We've got one ahead of us. To win in the way we won shows me that these guys still have fight in them. And I told them out in the huddle, out in right field, is we have nothing to lose. We're going to get on the bus. And I the one thing I demanded of them is we're going to finish our regular season like we started the regular season, with tons of energy being funneled out of the dugout. And we're going to be with each other for every pitch. And I feel any success we have early on in games or during games is going to continue to put more pressure on Georgia that they have to get something done. Nobody expects us to do anything, but it will surprise people.
This game was reminiscent to a lot of the blowouts that you guys had earlier in the year when you jump on some teams and just kind of basically pass the bat around. What did it mean to get that feeling back?
Well, I think for confidence level for our guys is tremendous. I told them before the game, I didn't know where their mindsets were. We had just come off a very rough weekend against LSU. They're out of school. They have a lot of time on their hands. And I told them, man, I said, we have two opportunities ahead of us. We have an opportunity to take Georgia one game at a time, and we know what we have to do. And we have an opportunity to finish with 30 wins if we win all four games. And I said, programs shoot for 40 wins. That's the mark of a great year. Well, we can't do that, so let's shoot for 30 wins. And I'm hoping that we have enough energy and pizzazz left in us to finish this off the right way. It would be a pretty special feeling for these guys. I know it got emotional tonight. Some guys playing their last game here at home. That has to be emotional for them. And I'm hoping that they don't want to take the uniforms off after Saturday.
How nice was it to be able to take out Vincent and Derek the way you did?
Well, I wish I could have done it to more of them, but I made my decision. I was going to do it to the four-year guys. Obviously, I had already taken Andy out of the game. Mm-hmm. Obviously, Moberg is injured, so I had the opportunity for those two, and I've done that at previous stops at Irvine and at Fullerton to let the fans recognize them and for them to have that special moment of coming off the field for the last time and people to be able to recognize them. So I did that, and I'm glad I did it, and I know that the players are very appreciative of that too.
Brody has the triple to kind of get it going in that one inning. This seemed like another example of him growing as a hitter, just how much you continue to see.
He's growing as a player, and it couldn't happen at a better time. Coach Thomas showed me some numbers the other day, and he's one of our most productive hitters late, and not only driving in runs, scoring a ton of runs, hitting extra base hits, and not to mention the great center field he plays for us, as good as anyone. It's very pleasurable to see his development happen right before your eyes, and I'm hoping that he takes a step kind of like what Jordan Rogers did last year. It played towards the tail end of the year, played well, and it carried over to his junior year, and if we could do that with Brody, that would be pretty special for us.
Speaking of Jordan, was that just resting the hamstring tonight?
Yes, it was. Got the call yesterday from Jeff Wood, our trainer, and said he was a little sore after the weekend, so didn't want to push the envelope. But I think that could serve two purposes for us. I think it may be good for him to have a day off. He's been struggling of late. And maybe a day away, let him get healthy, let him have a day away from some at-bats, maybe a blessing in disguise coming into the weekend.
Looking at this Georgia matchup, basically, how much have you had a chance to look at them at this point? How do you guys feel like you guys?
Well, I've seen them a lot on TV. I've seen them a lot on, I've seen them play. They'll be prepared for us. I think it's a good matchup for us. We're playing in their backyard, so that makes it tougher on us. We know what we have to do. We can't, and like I said to the team, we can't put pressure on ourselves. There's no pressure. Let's go play baseball. Let's have fun. And again, like I challenged our guys, let's get the energy level back to what we had at the start of the year. Because at the start of the year, when we were having success, I had never been around a dugout that was funneling so much energy. And losing causes that. Losing becomes like a disease. And we've lost a lot lately, and I think that's kind of crept in. But we have three chances to wear this uniform as a team, as the 2016 Vols. Let's make the best of it. And I'm hoping the bus ride down is safe and fun, and we'll get to work tomorrow night on their field and be ready to go on Thursday. I just hope I just hope, looking at the weather doesn't look real good down there this weekend. Mm-hmm. And the percentages are pretty high all 3 days of rain, and that won't bode well for us if there's some rain. So mm-hmm. we hope we could dodge the raindrops this weekend, too.
Okay. Good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
Okay. Thank you.